Hi, everybody. So you just finished hearing about Sergei Prokofiev's Story of the Peter and the Wolf, and now we're going to take a look at the music and the instruments behind that story that gave Sergei Prokofiev the inspiration for this. And so we start off with some of our main characters. We start off with the character of Peter. And what I'm going to do first is I'm going to show you the character of Peter. He might look a little bit different than he did in the book. But then I'm going to play the music for Peter's character, or for each character, and you have to try and figure out what instrument you think is playing for that character. So let's start first with Peter. Here's his instrument. Can you guess what his instrument is? That's right, it was the stringed instrument, the violin. Here we have the picture of the violin with the bow. Remember, you can play a stringed instrument either by using the bow with long, smooth strokes, or you can pluck the strings with your fingers. Next up, we have the bird. And do you think the bird would have a high or a low sound? And if you guessed what kind of sound that was, what type of instrument do you think might be playing for the bird? Let's take a listen. Figure it out yet? If you guessed the flute, you are correct. The woodwind instrument, one of the highest, not the highest, but one of the highest instruments in the woodwind family. Next up, we have the duck, the very whiny duck in our story. And let's hear what his whiny instrument is. This might not be as easy to figure out. Let me show you a picture. This is the oboe. Can you say oboe? So the oboe is another woodwind instrument like the flute, except the oboe has a piece of wood, two pieces of wood at the top here, called a reed, and you blow air through that, and the vibrations from your breath make the sound of the oboe, and your fingers press the metal keys on the oboe like this. So that is our whiny, whiny duck. Next up, we have the cat. The cat that crept through the grass and tried to attack the bird. Here is the sound of the cat. Did you figure it out? That is the clarinet. It looks very much like an oboe, but instead of the two pieces of wood, the reeds sticking up the top, the one piece of wood, the reed, is behind the mouthpiece right there, and you still put your fingers on the keys here to change the sound. And yes, the clarinet is also another type of a woodwind instrument. Next up, we have the grandfather. Again, the grandfather looks a little bit different here than he did in our story. And let's see what his instrument sounds like. This might be a new instrument for some of you. This is another woodwind instrument, but it is called the bassoon. Now the bassoon is very, very, very big. It's probably it's probably about the same size here as in relationship to the grandfather. The bassoon is actually two long tubes of wood. There's one here and there's one behind it, and it's capped at the bottom to join it together. And so the air starts here at the mouthpiece where the player blows through it. The air travels down the one tube and back up the top to make that low, low sound of the bassoon. And next up, we have the wolf, the wolf is actually two different instruments, and it's very creepy, creepy. So see if you can figure out what they are. So one instrument in the beginning and one instrument in the end. The ending instrument is the cymbal that had the big crash at the end. And the instrument in the beginning was one of our brass instruments, not a woodwind instrument this time, but a brass instrument. And as you learned from one of our, from our Scott Joplin lesson a few lessons ago, the brass instrument, the French horn, you blow into the mouthpiece here, and the air travels all the way through these twists and turns and comes out through the large end here called the bell. And that's the French horn. So the French horn and the cymbal were the two instruments played for the wolf. Now, next up, this might be a little bit of a challenge too. So this is the hunters. These are the hunters that came to save Peter and his friends at the end of our story. Take a listen. Decide? Well, that might be because there were a lot of instruments that were playing together for the hunters. The hunters were a collection of all of these instruments, all of these instruments in the woodwind family. We had the smallest, which is the piccolo, and then the flute and the clarinet and the oboe, which we heard earlier, as well as the bassoon. And I even threw the recorder in there because the recorder, yes, is also a wind instrument. So all of these instruments made the sounds for the hunters creeping through the woods to save Peter and his friends. And finally, the hunters' rifles that shot the warning shots in the woods. Were the big drums, the kettle drums, which is also called the timpani. Now, Mr. Prokofiev wrote all of these different songs, these different instrument pieces, to help support the story of Peter and the Wolf. So what I want you to do now is to close your eyes, and I'm gonna retell the story of Peter and the Wolf, a little shorter, different version. And I'm gonna add the music so you can see how the story changes if you add music to a story. Ready? So close your eyes, and we'll start from the beginning. Peter and the Wolf. One morning, Peter opened the gate and went out into the big green meadow. On the branch of a tree sat a bird. The little bird chirped happily. Came waddling around. She went for a swim in the pond in the meadow. The bird and the duck argued because the duck didn't want to fly, she wanted to swim. Suddenly, a cat came slinking up through the grass. shouted Peter, and the bird and the duck flew to safety. Grandpapa came out. Because Peter had gone to the meadow. It's dangerous in the meadow. If a wolf should come out of the forest, then what would you do? He demanded. Peter didn't pay any attention to his grandfather because he was a brave hunter. But grandfather took Peter home and locked the gate. No sooner was Peter gone than a wolf came out of the forest. The bird hid in the tree while the wolf paced below. Peter watched from the gate. He ran home, he got a rope and climbed up the stone wall. From the wall he climbed onto the tree, made a lasso and let it down, catching the wolf by the tail. The wolf tried to get loose. Just when it appeared that the wolf might get loose, the hunters came out of the woods. Fire their warning shots into the air. They helped Peter take the wolf to the zoo. The end. Now, was there a character missing in that story that was in our storybook? That's right, the veterinarian. And so that story is just a little bit different than the storybook that we read a little bit earlier. Now, so you've had a chance to see how music helps change a story, makes it a little bit more exciting, and adds a little bit of a deeper level to it. Now I wonder, is there a story that you really like that you could create some sounds or some music for yourself? Have a think about it, and good luck. Have fun creating.